and Credo Mutua, and list is actually boundless. For many years, South African writers demonstrated a remarkable sense of commitment to the values and aspiration of our society. They used their writings to confront the oppressive apartheid system. Through their work, they strengthened our advances towards freedom and democracy. Many of them lost their lives. Many others were persecuted, banned, and exiled. It is they who encourage and inspire us during our most difficult moments of our lives during apartheid, never to lose hope for the future. Indeed, this is a story that continues to remind us that we are united in our diversity. They did this to inspire social change and capture the painful rhythms, the aspiration as well as the agonies of our community. We can therefore never forget the role that these writers played in raising the consciousness of our people during the liberation struggle. Writers and authors who did not toe the line of writing that they were told to write and who challenged the apartheid government through their writings became the target of the security forces, subjected to torture, banning orders, and banishment from their country of birth. The truth is that even apartheid did not manage to kill the spirit of our people. Ladies and gentlemen, the Writers' Festival started its journey 10 years with one of the objectives to end the continuous struggle that our writers and authors experienced and what they are currently experiencing. Most importantly, it was implemented to create a platform to develop and nurture local writers and poets who previously lacked the means to access the publishing world. Through the Writers' Festival, local writers and poets have been able to access numerous opportunities over the past 10 years. As we mark a full decade since the Writers' Festival was launched, we take time out to pay tribute to the many men and women who have formed part of this great initiative. Some were administrators, some accomplished writers and poets, some were aspirant writers who have now become well-known and published writers. In our midst here this evening, we have Sabatang Pomukai, whom I believe can testify to the impact that the Writers' Festival had on this journey to become a well-known author who specializes in writing in his mother tongue of Setswana. We also acknowledge writers like May Ipileng Tlhakana, Mark Kutsiem, Johannes Majid, and most importantly, we want to acknowledge the contribution of Mr. Ricky Groenewald, who through his publishing company, The Ink Sword, managed to publish the work of 12 local authors, one of which was a winner of South African Literary Award, and another was a finalist. I am therefore pleased that this annual event is now becoming entrenched in the social and educational landscape of fabric of the Northern Cape. Quality of life is not only improved when you feed the physical, it goes hand in hand with feeding of the mind and the spirit. The Writers' Festival provides an exceptional opportunity to hear and interact with both published writers and aspiring writers in the different genres. Regardless of the depth of your insight into literature, I am confident that you will take away from these 4 days with a memorable experience that can be nurtured and enhanced for the future. Literature speaks the language of the imagination, and the study of literature is supposed to train and improve that imagination. I also believe that the festival will provide an excellent opportunity for writers to speak about their work, for the audience to hear from their very utterances and constructively engage with the many authors here on a number of levels. It is also hoped that this festival will encourage more would-be authors, particularly young ones, to take up the pen, or should I open the notebook, book app, or the smartphones, whatever that you do, but do it. Who knows? We may even bring the attention of the broader literary community and discovered writers already in our midst. We have wonderful stories to tell, to an important contribution to make to community writing, and indeed writing in general. Without the written word, life would be a very dull place. And as one who uses the word as a professional tool or instrument in my daily life, it is intrinsic part of being human, being able to connect and communicate. Therefore, in order for me to reassure, reaffirm, and persuade members of the community, I must command the language. And this I can only do through reading. And you guys are sources that generate our reading material. Ladies and gentlemen, let me also take this opportunity to encourage writers to write in their mother tongues. If you as a writer are not writing in your mother tongues, then you are not doing yourself, your mother tongue, and your fellow mother tongue speakers, you are doing them a disservice, actually. South Africans must enjoy distinctly South African stories told in South African voices. Together, these programs aim to keep book as an integral part of South African life. In our homes, our schools, our libraries, in coffee shops, and as part of our shared humanity. In conclusion, over the next 3 days, you will hear from authors as they discuss their work, engage in thought-provoking panel discussions, and take part in exciting and creative workshops for all ages. I also wish to express my sincere praise to the writers for their efforts in telling the South African story and my appreciation for your efforts in promoting the written word and writing in general. Writers comprise the intellectual elite, and may your elitism be infectious and spread like wildfire. I wish you all the best for the next 4 days. I know that you are going to enjoy it, and I thank you very much.